إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Ibrahim, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا كَلِمَةً طَيِّبَةً كَشَجَرَةٍ طَيِّبَةً أصلها ثابت وفرعها في السماء تؤتي أكلها كل حين بإذن ربها ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس لعلهم يتذكرون. Have you not reflected upon the similitude that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has set for you? A good word is like a good tree. The roots of that tree are firm because the seed is good. The word is good. And because the seed of good is good, and because the roots are firm, that tree will grow to the extent that its branches will reach the heaven. And that tree will produce harvest as per your need and according to the leave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, understand that similitude. A good word equal to the seed that you plant in the ground. And that good word, as Ibn Abbas said, it is La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. You plant it in your heart. Imagine La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah like a tree in your heart. The seed of that tree is La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Because this word is good, that tree will grow. The tree that we're talking about here that you planted in your heart is called the tree of Iman, faith, that you believe. Because the root of that tree are firm in the ground, that tree will grow to to the extent that its branches will reach the heaven. And any time you are in need for a fruit from the tree of Iman, the tree of faith, you will find it. I know some of you are saying, what are you talking about? Brothers and sisters in Islam, the tree of faith has fruits. Whenever you go through hardship, calamity, you will expect that tree to give you a fruit called patience. You pick it up from the tree. Whenever you commit a sin, the tree will produce for you a fruit called seek forgiveness. Ask Allah to forgive you. Don't continue committing sins. Whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses you with something that is good, that tree of faith that you have in your heart will urge you to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the similitude. In the midst of all the world talking about how terrible the economy is and how pessimistic the future is regarding your livelihood, your provision, a believer, because of that tree of faith that he planted in his heart, should not react in the same manner like the non-Muslims. If you truly have planted that tree of faith in your heart, right now, one fruit is needed from that tree. You know what's it called? Al-yaqeen. Certainty. Being certain. Certain of what? As a believer. Here they are in the media, you're going to lose your house, you may not have a job. A believer is certain. Certain of what? إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. Allah is the provider, the strong. وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا وَيَعْلَمُ مُسْتَقَرَّهَا وَمُسْتَوْدَعَهَا كُلٌّ فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. There is no creature that crawl in the face of this earth, but its sustenance with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide for animals, you think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to provide for you if you truly have planted the tree of Iman, the tree of faith in your heart, and you water the tree with your obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that you sustain the growth of that tree by staying from the haram. فَمَا ظَنُّكَ بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. What do you know about your Lord then? وَكَأَيِّن مِّن دَابَّةٍ لَا تَحْمِلُ رِزْقَهَا اللَّهُ يَرْزُقُهَا وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. How many creature, how many animals out there that they do not carry their sustenance in their back, Allah sustains them and you. وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. And He is all here. He knows that you need provision. He is aware of you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, a lot of us are so skeptical of this, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took an oath to the extent that a Bedouin heard these verses in Surah Al-Dhariyat being recited, وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوَعَدُونَ فَوَرَبِّ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّهُ لَحَقٌ مِثْلَ مَا أَنَّكُمْ تَنْطِقُونَ. In the heaven is your rizq, is your provision. your provision and whatever you are promised. Look at this. By the Lord of the heaven and the earth, it is true. The Bedouin heard this. He said, من أغضب الجليل حتى أقسم. Who made the most exalted angry that he took an oath on this? Brothers and sisters in Islam, listen to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam fil hadith that is compiled in Sahih Muslim, hadith Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As. Inna Allah kataba maqadir al-khalaiq 50 bi 50 sana 50 sanatin qabla an yakhluq 50 alf sanatin qabla an yakhluq as-samawati wal ard wa kana 'arshuhu 'ala al-ma'. In another wording, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote your provision, the paycheck that you're getting right now, it's written in your books when 50,000 years before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created heavens and earth. What are you worried about? What are you worried about? Should you be anxious now? Should you be alert? You should not, as a believer. This is the beauty of the tree of faith. This is the beautiful package of Iman, that you do not panic like the non-Muslim panic, because you are certain that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide for you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the lack of understanding of these concepts lead a lot of Muslims to seek provision through haram. You not being certain that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the provider, is the strong, is the one who provides for you, you lacking that knowledge will cause you to seek your rizq through haram means. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam expressed this in a hadith Abi Umama radiyallahu an, the hadith fi Hilyat al-Awliya and authenticated by Sheikh al-Albani rahimahullah. Here it is. Inna ruh al-Qudus nafatha fi ru'i. The Holy Spirit, Jibreel alayhi salam, revealed to me. Listen to this. أَنَّ نَفْسًا لَنْ تَمُوتَ حَتَّى تَسْتَكْمِلَ أَجَلَهَا وَرِزْقَهَا. No soul shall die before it receives its complete provision written for it in the dunya and before living the time that is ordained for it. Here it is now. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Be conscious of Allah. وَأَجْمِلُوا فِي الطَّلَبِ. And seek your provision through halal means. Here is the Rasulullah ﷺ is warning you. وَلَا يَحْمِلَنَّ أَحَدَكُمُ اسْتُبْطَاءُ الرِّزْقِ أَنْ يَطْلُبَهُ بِمَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ. Do not let being worried about your provision drive you to seek it from haram means. Let me go get a loan and pay interest. Be riba. Let me receive a bribery now. Let me cheat in the books. Let me deceive. Let me make a haram deal with that person. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do not allow being worried about your provision cause you to seek it from haram mean. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُنَالُ مَا عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِطَاعَتِهِ. You will only get what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordained for you through His obedience. Don't make the worries that you have regarding provision, regarding your rizq, drive you to sin, to seek earning that provision from haram. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I am sure all of you are experts in knowing how to earn your provision through the material means, which is, by the way, part of that deen too. But in 10 minutes or so, I just want to share with you some of the ways that will help you gain and increase your provision from Allah. The one that we said He is the provider anyways. There are some things that you could do, and it will help you to gain more provisions, more rizq. You know, the first of which is what? Trust Allah. Do you trust Allah? Wallahi, akhi, the Muslims right now trust people, trust countries, trust powers more than they trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tawakkul. وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Whoever places his trust in Allah, Allah will suffice him. Wallahi. By Allah, if the ummah trust that piece of verse, Allah will take us out of our darknesses. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fi hadith that is recorded by Imam al-Tirmidhi, Musnad al-Imam Ahmad, Hadith Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiyallahu an, and the majority of you know this hadith. Listen to this. لو أنكم توكلون على الله حق توكله لرزقكم كما يرزق الطير تغدو خماصا وتروح بطانا. If you rely, if you trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way that He should be trusted, and underline this, the way that He should be trusted, He will provide for you like He provides for the birds. They fly in the morning with empty stomachs, and they come back at night with full stomachs. All that they have to do is to fly. Brothers and sisters in Islam, trusting Allah does not mean that you abandon the utilization of the means. Absolutely not. Trusting Allah is an act of the heart. That heart should be trusting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But your limbs should be seeking the means. But your heart is tied to Allah. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala still have for us a sign from a long time ago. A miracle from a long time ago that we all know, my brothers and sisters in Islam. And you know what? This sign was the harvest, the produce of tawakkul. I'm talking about the well of Zamzam. The well of Zamzam. A well that people still drink from it until this very day. They take its water all over the world. And still running. Because you know what? It was the produce of tawakkul, trusting Allah. Hadith Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma fil Bukhari, when Ibrahim alayhi salam took Hajar and the little baby, little infant, to Mecca, placed them in the desert, akhi, in the desert. Just look around the Haram in Mecca. Don't look in the Haram, no. The area where she was placed was like the mountain area. These dark mountains. Place them there with little to drink, with little to eat. A woman taught humanity tawakkul, how to trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She knew that Ibrahim alayhi salam did not do this just for the cause or just for the purpose of harming her. But she wanted to hear it from him. Why are you doing this? He's about to leave them. A woman with her baby in the desert. No man is around. Why are you doing this? Why are you doing this? Three times. And at the end, she told him, she asked him, أَلَّهُ أَمَرَكَ بِهَذَا. Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command you to do this? فَأَوْمَأَ بِرَأْسِهِ He did not even say a word. He said yes. Look, go. لَنْ يُضَيِّعُنَا لَنْ يُضَيِّعَنَا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not waste us. Go. What did she do? She sat down and she waited until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the help. No. She saved the means. But her heart was so attached to the fact that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will relieve her from her burden. She ran between those two mountains. As-Safa wal-Marwa. 7 rounds. Right now we do it while we're walking under the air condition. We still get tired. Imagine her running between those two mountains in that environment. And she calls, Sah, Sah. No one is answering. She did not give up. 7 rounds. Towards the end, she saw Jibreel alayhi salam touching earth. She approached him. And this portion of the hadith in Mu'jam al-Tabarani, hadith Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu anhu, Jibreel alayhi salam asked her, Who are you? She said, Ana ummu waladi Ibrahim. I am the mother of the son of Ibrahim. Look at this. She knows Ibrahim, knowing up there. A woman identifies herself through her husband. وَلِمَنْ وَكَلَكُمَا And to whom did he leave you like this, you and your baby? قَالَتْ وَكَلَنَا لِلَّهِ He left us to Allah. You know what he told her? وَكَلَكُمَا لِكَافٍ He left you to someone who will take care of you. And that is why I'm here. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the concept of tawakkul need to be revisited by a lot of Muslims. You see, we ended up with two ends. Some of us believing in the means so much that we abandon the action of the heart, which is trusting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some of us, like those at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, came from Yemen without money, without provision to do Hajj. And once they are asked, how are you going to eat and drink? They said, we are mutawakkilun. The verse was revealed, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى No, take your provision with you. The concept of tawakkul needs to be revisited by a lot of us. في سنن الترمذي الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم was asked by a Bedouin حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه يا رسول الله about the camel that all you know you all know يا رسول الله should I leave the camel loose or should I tie it and do tawakkul الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم told him no اعقلها وتوكل seek the means by tying the camel But at the same time, do not allow your heart to believe that this time of the camel is the reason why you will find the camel. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep your camel for you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, another thing, another mean, another way of gaining the provision from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala beside tawakkul is istighfar. Asking Allah to forgive us. إِذَا كُنْتَ فِي نِعْمَةٍ فَرْعَهَا فَإِنَّ الذُّنُوبَ تَزِيلُ النِّعَمِ If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with something, you better guard it. Guard that ni'mah by obeying Allah. Because if you sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take that ni'mah, that blessing from you. When Prophet Nuh alayhi salam said in reporting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what he did with his people, فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. I told them to do istighfar, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. Look, what is going to happen if you ask Allah to forgive you, if you do tawbah? يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. Tawbah, if you say astaghfirullah, 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 I repent to you, Allah will send rain to you in abundance. وَيُمْدِدُكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. And He will provide you, increase you in wealth, in children. And He will make for you gardens and rivers. Because of what? Astaghfirullah. Tabbillahi alik, I'm asking all of you, how many astaghfirullah do you do every day? Don't answer. Answer you, between you and Allah. Fi sunan Abi Dawood, hadith Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu anhuma, he said that we used to count 100 times in one sitting. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to ask Allah to forgive him. Rasulullah, someone whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiven all his previous and all his future sins, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him in one sitting 100 times. Sins, brothers and sisters, and that is why the whole world is taking that direction, because sins. Gay marriage, man and women are getting married. Man and man, man, men and men are getting married. Women, lesbianism, whatever it is, going. And this is what got the empires before us down. That very thing. And we're taking the same path. As Muslims, we are entrusted of holding our neighbors. Go back. If we cannot do it between us and ourselves, we cannot help them, brothers and sisters in Islam. Hadith Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu fi sahih fi sahih fi sunan at-Tirmidhi fi sunan Abi Dawud, man akthara min al-istighfar, whoever says astaghfirullah a lot, look at this, ja'ala Allahu lahu min kulli hammin faraja wa min kulli dhiqin makhraja wa razaqahu min haythu la yahtasib. Ya Allah, whoever says astaghfirullah a lot, astaghfirullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make a way out for him at any time he faces a hardship. Whenever he's distressed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ease that distress, and He will provide for him from means that he has never imagined. Al-istighfar. Al-istighfar. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hadith Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, تابعوا بين الحج والعمرة. Keep up performing Hajj and Umrah. We know that Hajj and Umrah cost money. But look at this. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَإِنَّهُمَا يَنْفِيَانِ الْفَقْرَى. They will help you to get rid of poverty. You know why? Because of the next word. Al-faqra wa-dhunub, and sins. You see, sins are the reason why for poverty. Once you go and perform Hajj that is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will come out of your sins. Then the poverty will be removed as well. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Brothers and sisters in Islam, you know the best way to have provision is if you work for the hereafter. Every single day you wake up in the morning and you say, I'm going to do for the hereafter. I'm not going to work for this dunya. You make your own goal the hereafter. And this is not my talk. Listen to this hadith. Fi Sunan al-Tirmidhi. Hadith Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man ja'ala al-akhirata hamma. Whosoever makes the hereafter his main focus. I'm not concerned about a house here or a... No. I want to work for the hereafter. Today, whatever I'm going to do, I want it to contribute to me being saved. Going to Jannah. If you make this your goal, your focus, look at this. جَعَلَ اللَّهُ غِنَاهُ فِي قَلْبِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will place your riches in your heart. You will always see yourself rich. Because being rich or poor is irrelevant, akhi. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Hadith Abi Hurairah fil Bukhari, the book of Riqaq, لَيْسَ الْغِنَى عَنْ كَثْرَةِ الْعَرَضِ وَلَكِنَّ الْغِنَى غِنَى النَّفْسِ. Being rich is not about having 3-5 houses or 10-7 cars or 10 cellular phones. No. Being rich, that you see yourself rich. That you're content with what you have. Okay, you tell me, you have $1 trillion. And someone else has $10. The one with the trillion is not happy. He wants more. The one with the 10 is happy. Who's the rich and who's the poor? The poor is the one with the trillion. He's like drinking from a salty ocean. The more he drinks, the more he dehydrates himself. He wants more. But the one with the 10 is happy. So if the hereafter is your goal, you're working for the hereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will place your riches in your heart. Listen to the next one. وَجَمْعَ عَلَيْهِ شَمْلَهِ. He's going to have a very tranquil, relaxed lifestyle. He wakes up in the morning, he goes to the masjid, he brings fajr, and then he goes to work. He's happy with his job, alhamdulillah. He pays his bill. His wife is very content with masha. Relaxed. That's what he's worried about. Listen to the third one. وَأَتَتْهُ الدُّنْيَا وَهِيَ رَاغِمَةٌ. And the dunya will come to him forcefully. Look at the other side of the story. وَمَنْ جَعَلَ الدُّنْيَا هَمَّهُ. And if someone makes the dunya his hum, his goal is about the dunya. How can I be richer? How can I be more powerful? Dunya, 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 dunya. جَعَلَ اللَّهُ فَقْرَهُ بَيْنَ عَيْنَيْهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make himself see himself always. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him see himself always poor. As we mentioned, because it's irrelevant. وَفَرَّقَ عَلَيْهِ شَمْلَهِ. And he's distracted in the corridors of life. He probably has 10 cellular phones. He probably have 10 cars. He probably have 5 houses. But he's worried about a lawsuit. He's worried about a custody. He's worried about somebody sued him. He's worried about... He's distracted. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَثَلُهُ كَمَثَلِ الْكَلْبِ أَعَزَّكُمُ اللَّهِ إِن تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْهِ يَلْهَفْ أَوْ تَتْرُكُهُ يَلْهَفْ. He's like a dog. May Allah honor all of you, inshallah. But this parable is given from the Quran. You know something about the dog? He always sticks his tongue out, whether he's under the shade or whether he's under the sun. All the time. That's what Allah does with somebody who goes for the dunya. Look at the third one. وَلَمْ يَأْتِهِ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَا كُتِبَ لَهُ. And he will only get from the dunya what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote for him. We used to say it back in the wilderness, اجري يا ابن آدم جري الوحوش غير رزقك بتحوش. Oh son of Adam, run the run of the beast. You only get what is written for you. فالآخرة أخي, Work for the Akhirah. Work for the hereafter, inshallah. One last thing. Dua. Dua. Ali ibn Abi Talib and the author in Sunan al-Tirmidhi. A man came to him. Ya Ali, I have a lot of debts. Can you help me? Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu told him, shall I teach you words that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught me? This is how I can help you. Shall I teach you a dua, a supplication that you can make? Said yes. Says, Allahumma kfini bihalalika an haramik wa bifadlika an mansuwak. Oh Allah, make me happy with the halal and make me happy with whatever you've given me. We talked about Hajar and Ismail being left alone near al-Haram. Ibrahim alayhi salam seek the means. You know what mean was in his capacity? Ad-du'a. Rabbana inni askantu min dhurriyati biwadin ghayri di zar'in inda baytika al-muharram. ربنا ليقيموا الصلاة فاجعل أفئدة من الناس تهوي إليهم وارزقهم من الثمرات لعلهم يشكرون. Oh Allah, I have placed my son and my wife in a barren land near your house. Oh Allah, give. دعاء أخي, دعاء. Brothers and sisters in Islam, لو أنكم توكلون على الله حق توكله لرزقكم كما يرزق الطير تغدو خماصا وتروح بطانا. If you place your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way that He should be relied on, He will provide for you like He provides for the birds. They fly in the morning with empty stomach and they come at night with full stomachs. A believer should not be anxious because of what they read in the paper regarding the economy. A believer should not be anxious because of what they hear in the radio regarding the economy. A believer should not be anxious because of what they see on the TV, the internet regarding the economy. Because the believer believes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the provider. إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. But a believer must do something first. In order to have that certainty, he must plant the tree of faith in his heart. And the seed of the tree is Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم إنا نسألك رزقا حلالا طيبا. اللهم إنا نسألك رزقا حلالا طيبا. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفقر والكفر. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفقر والكفر. اللهم أصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا, وأصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا, وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا, واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير, واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم, وأقم الصلاة.